What's up, guys? It's Josh with Upstate Brush Control. Stepped in a pothole. We got a retention pond today. As you can see, pretty overgrown. It's not what you want. So Greenville County's been on this lady to get this cleaned up. So John's out looking at jobs today. So it's me, Willie, Micah. Willie just left. He's getting the excavator. We brought the Ventrac and the Skidster with us this morning. So yeah, pretty self-explanatory. I'm gonna come in here, rough this edge out with the forestry mulcher. And unfortunately the bottom is pretty wet. So we're gonna try to get in there with the Ventrac, do what we can, but it's gonna be a lot of hand cutting today. So I'll come in, I'll rough this out, get what I can. We're gonna clean up down here. Clean up all this scrub stuff on the outlet where the water's shooting out of. So got the Skidster warming up. Mike is getting the saws ready. It's all our gear. Yeah. Trucks are way up there, so brought the boots today. So yeah, I'm gonna rough that out, rough this out, and then we'll see what we're looking at. And then we'll try to finish our way from back there, coming back here, so. Should be a party. Right, Micah?
What?
Should be a party.
Bro.
All right, so I think someone started to do this part, because the end is that berm right there. When they got down to here, they're like, nah, bro, we're out of here. So it's pretty wet. We would just make them a big mess if we brought the skid steer down here. We're gonna try to bring the Ventrac out here, see what we can do with that. There's some pretty thicker stuff, so we'll see what we can do. I would like to try to get this edge with the skid steer, but ground's pretty wet. You really don't want to rut up retention ponds. You really want to try to keep the dirt, you know, just as it was. You don't want a bunch of silt going down the creeks and stuff like that. So we're gonna go on the other side, rough that out real quick. Track can do real quick. think a stick popped that belt off. Alright, got it back on. Still intact. Probably a little rough on it right now. We're just trying to see what it's capable of. So far, fantastic. I absolutely love this thing. Doesn't look like super good, but I got all this roughed out. I mean, we would have to hand cut all this stuff if we didn't have this Ventrac. So, super thankful for it. This thing is a tank, man. Absolute tank. Oh, yeah.
back here on the job, finished up looking at several jobs. Hopefully I will end up getting some of that work here. Guy's doing a great job. Mike has got a little issue with his back. He's like all hunched over on us and everything. I came out here, I'm like, dude, are you okay? And he's like, I'll go to the chiropractor tomorrow. I'm like, just go home, man. I felt bad for him. He's all hunkered over and stuff, but so I'm back here. We got that side all pulled up on the bank, up on the bank. And then this side here, doing the same thing. And I got a little bit more left to do right through here. I'll get about to there, and then I'll let Willie do it. And then I'll hop up there and grind that off. So, guys doing a good job. It is definitely wetter than I anticipated. Thing with these ponds is, you know, it could be months before it's completely dry, and customers want it cut, county wants it cut and everything, and it's really not that big a deal. I mean, if it's a little messy, but we try to keep them clean, or, you know, not rut it up and everything. But I don't know, it's kind of one of those things that it has to be done, but you make a mess and create silt doing it. So I don't know what to do. You know, they don't want to wait till June or July, and this is what they get. So it's kind of a bummer, but it is what it is. I'm just kind of taking this stuff right here and flinging it up on the side. The guys are going through and getting areas that the mulcher or the Ventrac didn't get, little stubs and stuff like that. So there's Josh. And there's Willie. All right, we got the tools. So, I'm gonna be upset. The old GoPro died, so got the old phone. So I'm gonna see if I can't set her up here without knocking off this snake-infested outlet structure. I mean, does that not look like the biggest snake habitat you've ever seen? Blech. Blech.
Mission here. The old Ventrac stuck up to the belly pan, which is only like 10 inches, if that, off the ground. But Willie's grabbing a chain. We're gonna see if we can suck her on out of here. Lovely.
Those people that, the guys that did that pond, I don't know if Josh told you or not, but it's a, owned by two different properties, or two different owners. So, they got the easy side, the uphill side, and this is the inlet right here. So hardly anything goes up that direction. Take that back. It's a little moist down in that area right there. So I got that side all done right there. I'm gonna go through and hit the this stuff piled up on the right side of the pond here. rut. I'm trying to do this one-handed. Ah, not what I wanted to do. She is complete. We was just going through and making sure nothing's big up along that edge there. Got all the trash picked up out of it, all the beer cans and tennis balls and little, they always come down the storm drains and stuff like that. So yeah, Josh took the Ventrac back to the shop. We're not too far away. We're not too far away. What is that thing? Big old mud clod. We're here in Travelers Rest, South Carolina. So, Josh ran the Ventrac up to make it easier to get everything on the trailers. And we're gonna drop one machine off for a job for tomorrow. And then, Willie's got a big day tomorrow.
Pretty exciting. Yeah. I don't know if I wanna share anything that's like signed.
Like any like little teaser?
Somewhere to live.
Somewhere to live.
Nothing, I don't know yet. We just gotta make sure, gotta sign some papers.
Yeah, we'll keep you posted on it. But we're gonna get this stuff loaded up here. And Josh should be back here any minute.